From the title of the poem, Rain on the Roof, we can make out that the poem is about the rain. See, by seeing the title itself, we can understand maybe the poem is talking about rain. The poet is telling us about the memories he has of the rain. The sound of the raindrops falling on the roof of his house brings back sweet memories of the past. That is what we are going to see in the poem. So this poem is about rain, and poet is getting some memories from his life when he hears the raindrops, the sound of raindrops falling on the roof. So let us see the poem stanza by stanza. The first stanza: when the humid shadows hover over all the starry spheres, and the melancholy darkness gently weeps in rainy tears. What a bliss to press the pillow of a cottage chamber bird and lie listening to the patter of a soft rain overhead. So here are some new words you can see, like humid, hover, melancholy, bliss and all. So humid means something which is full of moisture. You can just underline if you want. Just with the pencil, you can underline in your textbook. And a hover means move around something, okay? Hover. You can see here, humid shadows hover. When these shadows were moving here and there, you can move around something. Melancholy means sad. Bliss means happiness. Okay, now let us see what the poet says. The poet is saying that when the sky is full of these clouds, which are moisture laden, are full of water and are about to bring rain, when such clouds hover around in the sky, over all the starry spheres. Starry spheres refers to the sky at night time, which is full of stars. So now, by looking at the sky, he is thinking that the climate is changing, maybe it's going to be raining now. At that time, huge clouds which are full of moisture move around in the sky, and the sad darkness of the night is wiped off by the raindrops, which seem like tears falling from the sky. So that is what he is saying in the first stanza. When it looks like raining, huge cloud which are full of moisture move around in the sky, and the sad darkness of the night is wiped off. The poet is comparing raindrops to tears, and he says that a dark sky, which seems to be very sad, it appears as if it is crying, and the raindrops are the tears shed by it. He adds that it is like a blessing to lie on the bed in his room. Cottage chamber means bedroom, we can say, and listens to the sound made by raindrops falling on the roof. So what he says, when it is a dark cloud, it is like sad, and the tears of raindrops wiping them out, and it is very clear. I'm very happy to sleep in the cottage chamber by hugging my pillow. So he is very happy that. Okay, let us see second stanza. Every tingle on the shingles has an echo in the heart, and a thousand dreamy fancies in the busy being start, and a thousand recollections weave their air threads into woof, as I listen to the patter of a rain upon the roof. Here, what is tingle? Tingle is like a short, light raining sound, and the shingles, rectangular wooden tiles used on roofs. Poet is expressing his feelings when he hears the raindrops falling on the rooftop of his house. He says that every tingle on the shingles has an echo in the heart. So now he is having a feeling when the raindrops are falling on the roof. Where it is falling? Tingles on the shingles. It is falling and making a sound on the shingles. What is that shingles? Rectangular wooden tiles used on the roof. In the olden houses, you can see in the roof, on the roof they will attach some wooden tiles also. So when it is falling, when the raindrops are falling on that, a kind of sound, echoing sound is coming, and it has an echo in the heart. It is making some memories, creating some sound or memories in his heart. Whenever he hears rain falling on the rooftop, the sound repeats in his heart, and in his dreams, he has many different fanciful imaginations. He asks that the sound of the rain falling on the rooftop creates many new different dreams in his mind. So now what he says, when he hears the sound of raindrops, so many thoughts, memories are fanciful imaginations are coming and going. And also when he hears the sound of the rain falling on the rooftop, it creates many new different dreams in his mind. Again, he recollects many memories of the past which come back into his mind as a dream. So he says that as he listens to the patter of the rain upon the roof, he has many new dreams in his mind, and the memories of the past come back in the form of dreams. Okay, let us see stanza 3. Now in memory comes my mother, as she used in years agone to regard the darling dreams ere she left them till the dawn. Oh, I feel her fond look on me as I list to this refrain which is played upon the shingles by the patter of the rain. So here you can see a word ir, E-R-E. It is old poetic word of for before. If you want to say before, in old style they used to say ir. Okay, here the poet introduces his mother. He says that he's dreaming of his mother. Now he is dreaming of his mother. As he had told in the previous stanza that rain brings memories of the past, it is the memory of his mother who is no longer alive. So when he was listening raindrop sound on the roof, the memory of mother comes in his mind. So now his mother is no more. In the past, she used to love him a lot. She used to consider him a darling, and she would let him sleep till daybreak and have sweet dreams. So usually when mother was with him, she used to love him and make him to sleep properly by seeing sweet dreams and all. The poet can still feel that his mother is looking at him as he listens to the song made by the raindrops falling on the rooftop of his room. So when he is hearing the sound, listening the sound of raindrops falling on the rooftop, he can listen the sound of mother, like he is getting the memory of the mother. The sound of the rain makes him correlate his past with his present. That is why the poet is moved by the sound of the raindrops on the shingles of his room. Whenever he hears this sound, it brings back memories of the past, and he is reminded of his mother. So now he is just laying down and listening the sound of raindrops, and when he was listening the sound of raindrops, there were lots of memories came in his mind, especially the memory of his loving mom who used to love him and making him to sleep well by seeing the sweet dreams. So I will give you a short summary now. The poet Rain on the Roof talks about the poet's varied reactions to the sound of raindrops falling on the roof of his house. He says that the raindrops at night are like tears shed by the sad, dark night. He loves to lay in bed and hear rain falling on the roof of his room because it gets back sweet memories of the past. He says that the sound of raindrops helps him fall asleep and gives him sweet dreams. He has memories of his loving mother who would put them to sleep. So when he was listening the sound of raindrops, he can peacefully sleep with the memories of mother who used to make him to sleep peacefully when she was alive.